This video is sponsored by Qualcomm Technologies. This is Wi-Fi 7 in action. And as you can see, I'm doing a Wi-Fi speed test from my phone, completely wireless. And I'm hitting speeds above 1 gigabit. This almost feels like a holy grail moment, something we've been waiting for with each successive Wi-Fi release, but something that Wi-Fi 6 and even 6E could barely achieve. But now with Wi-Fi 7, the game has legitimately been changed. So what does this mean for you? Well, imagine no more Wi-Fi dead zones, no more battles for bandwidth, even when everyone's streaming, gaming, or working from home. Wi-Fi 7 isn't just incrementally better, it's the kind of upgrade that changes how we interact with the digital world. And by the end of this video, you'll see why Wi-Fi 7 isn't just a new standard, but a new standard bearer for what's possible in your digital life. But let's back up for a minute. Recently, Qualcomm made waves during their Wi-Fi 7 day event where they had several products using their Wi-Fi 7 chips out on display, and I was genuinely surprised by just how many there were. It was clear that they're paving the way for everyone, consumers, businesses, everyone, to benefit from this new tech. And it's about more than just faster speeds. It's about a transformation in the reliability and efficiency of our connections, and Qualcomm is at the forefront of this revolution. And why does this matter to you? Because it's about elevating your everyday experience. It's about your devices working better, your home running smarter, and your online world responding faster. Qualcomm doesn't sell consumer products, so instead they're selling a promise of a more connected, more seamless world. And from what we've seen, they're delivering. All right, so let's demystify Wi-Fi 7. In the simplest terms, it's the latest generation of Wi-Fi, but that hardly does it justice. Picture a futuristic urban transit system. Each lane is optimized not just for speed, but for efficiently managing a diverse range of vehicles, from bikes to buses. Wi-Fi 7 is like this advanced system, offering a remarkable blend of speed and intelligent traffic management. It stands out with its ability to handle more data through wider 320 megahertz channels. This isn't just about raw speed, it's about how Wi-Fi 7 smartly directs data traffic, ensuring each device gets its fair share of bandwidth. It's this sophisticated approach that leaves previous iterations of Wi-Fi in the rearview mirror. But Qualcomm takes this a step further with high-band simultaneous multi-link. HBS multi-link can aggregate both the 5 gigahertz and 6 gigahertz bands simultaneously, or it can use those two high bands to create high-speed links across two devices. High-speed 320 megahertz channels are the widest possible channels with Wi-Fi 7 and are able to cut the data transfer and download times in half compared to Wi-Fi 6. HBS multi-link is designed to deliver the maximum bandwidth available by aggregating two 160 megahertz bands, creating the widest channel to any access point. This means everything you do online, from gaming to streaming, becomes an experience in seamless, lightning-fast connectivity. Wi-Fi 7 packs more data into each signal, making your downloads and uploads lightning fast. But I ask again, what does all this mean for you? It means lower latency for one, which is crucial for online gaming, virtual and augmented reality, and real-time video chats. No more lag, no more stuttering, just seamless, smooth interaction. Wi-Fi 7 isn't just a step, but a quantum leap forward, ensuring that your online experience keeps pace with the rapid speed of today. And Qualcomm isn't new to the connectivity game. They've been leading it for years. But with Wi-Fi 7, they're not just leading, they're setting the pace for the entire industry with a commitment to make these faster speeds available to all of us. They understand that for Wi-Fi 7 to truly make an impact, it needs to be accessible. It needs to be widely available, not just for the tech fans like you and me who are gonna run to Amazon and Best Buy to upgrade our routers as soon as we can afford to. That's why they're working with manufacturers and carriers to bring Wi-Fi 7 to as many devices and homes as possible. It's not just about having the best technology, it's about making that technology available to work for everyone. Now, onto my Wi-Fi 7 experience. I've been testing Wi-Fi 7 here in my home with the Netgear Orbi 970 mesh system, which has been really impressive. Now, I've got to say, I've experienced going from Wi-Fi generation to Wi-Fi generation before, Wi-Fi 4 to Wi-Fi 5 to 6 to 6E. Anytime there's a new version of Wi-Fi, I'm an early adopter, but this is the first time that I've experienced speeds so drastically different just from upgrading my Wi-Fi network. So taking the speeds aside for a moment, the hardware is built to match the software. With the integration of two 10 gigabit and four 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports. This mesh system is keeping us future-proofed for years to come, supporting internet speeds of up to 10 gigabits per second. And here at my home, I do have a 10 gigabit fiber connection, and this is the first mesh system that lets me take advantage of all that speed. But what's speed without stability? That's where the magic of a mesh network comes in. Unlike traditional routers, which broadcast Wi-Fi from a single point, the Orbi 970 series blankets your entire home with consistent coverage as you place the nodes in different areas. And in turn, you're eliminating those dreaded Wi-Fi dead zones completely. Mesh networks are only as strong as their backhaul, the dedicated channel that they use to communicate between units. With Wi-Fi 7's enhanced capabilities, the Orbi 970 series backhaul is a super highway, allowing massive amounts of data to flow unimpeded throughout your home. This means that those super fast speeds promised by Wi-Fi 7 are maintained across every inch of your network. The Orbi 970 series is available now, and as the holidays approach, it occurs to me that this is an incredible gift for that special techie in your life, or, you know, for yourself. Hashtag self-care. Consider adding it to your wish list or surprising a loved one with the ultimate Wi-Fi upgrade. I will leave a link down in the description below if you want to check it out for yourself. Now let's get back into these speed tests. What's most impressive for me is that unlike previous Wi-Fi generations, your older devices will benefit from Wi-Fi 7 too. For example, using Wi-Fi 6 and Wi-Fi 6E devices also resulted in a speed boost due to the better throughput and range. So here I am testing a Wi-Fi 6 smartphone, for example. And as you can see, these speeds are great. And here is a Wi-Fi 6E laptop. Once again, no complaints there. Now this Xiaomi 13 Pro supports Wi-Fi 7, as does the OnePlus 11 Pro and OnePlus Open Foldable. And again, when it comes to these devices, take a look at these speeds. Again, this is completely wireless. You are matching and even exceeding the speeds of a wired gigabit network, which is just incredible. This is a real world look at the differences you can expect when setting up a Wi-Fi 7 network. I don't know about you, maybe I'm just a huge nerd, but this is so exciting to me. Wireless connection that is as fast as a wired one. Anyway, to all of us, here's the faster downloads, smoother streams, and a world where our digital potential is unleashed. Stay connected, stay fast, and stay tuned for more tech insights that will keep you ahead of the curve. Thanks for watching as always, guys. I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.